We're here at the Hill Grove in Monaghan today to celebrate the project that's been running now for just over 2.5 years. The Driving Change project has two phases. The first phase is where we work with firefighters on the border region. Getting together, knowing each other firstly, that's an important part, but also to work with the terminology, the policies and procedures, and trying to get an understanding of them. The second part of the project is where we work with young people to identify road safety issues that are relevant to them in their area, in their community, and to come up with solutions to some of those problems or the issues that they have. That's solutions that the young people come up with, not the project officers or the youth coaches. And today is all about celebrating the work that we have achieved and that they have achieved so far.
It's been a wonderful 2.5 years. I've had the privilege of working with very, very professional guys from a range of different backgrounds, both Kerry in terms of her youth work experience and Martin and Rory from their fire service. Everybody's brought their own special expertise to it. They've all been very passionate about driving change, and I think, you know, from what you've seen in there, we've been able to make a positive difference both in terms of the fire service stuff and the work we've done with young people.
It has led to a huge improvement in working practices in terms of our method of response to dealing with RTCs. It has generated goodwill and great cooperation between the services north and south, in that no matter who turns out at an incident from whichever station, all of the services are very comfortable in working together to deal and to give the best level of service to the casualties involved.
Well, I think it's a huge impact, and we're looking at a memorandum of understanding where the closest fire service will attend the scene of an accident or a crash, and that's very important because time is of the essence.
It's definitely made me more aware around, you know, around this, my own area, and that how to stop, how it can be stopped, basically, like, you know, and how much it is a problem.
Oh, the impact that the project has had, in my opinion, is that we have got to know our colleagues north and south of the border. That will improve the response level that the people in the local area will get should they be unlucky enough to be involved in a road traffic collision. But it also has, I suppose, increased the knowledge and understanding of young people and the wider community of the dangers and the need to take care on the roads. And hopefully it will reduce the number of collisions and road deaths on our roads, especially in the border area, but throughout the island of Ireland.
I think all projects have a natural end. I'll be sad to move on, but I think we have probably taken this project as far as we can in its current format. We've set up a model that can be followed, copied and imitated, but I think in its current format the personalities need to change now to keep that level of momentum that it needs. So I'm sad that it's over, but it's over, and we'll see what comes next.
It has changed my working with the young people, has changed my opinion of young people, definitely. The press sometimes give them a bad name, but they work very hard and they come up with some fantastic solutions. Sorry to see the project finish. I'd like to keep going at it, but unfortunately have to go back and do some other real work.